Chapter 4
Hyacinth Macaws.
Mariana stares at a huge tree so tall that she has to shade her eyes from the sun to see the leaves. Like on the day with Raphael, Mariana perches on a wooden deck among the trees. This time, she visits a palm savanna with Fernanda Alves, another friend of her parents. Fernanda is a scientist who studies birds. Now, Fernanda points to a hole in the trunk of the tall tree.
A hyacinth macaw has built a nest in this tree.
Fernanda says, she hands a pair of binoculars to Mariana.
This kind of tree is old enough and wide enough for a nest.
Fernanda says,
macaws can hollow out the soft wood with their beak.
How can you tell there is a nest there?
Mariana asks. She only sees a dark spot on the trunk, not a nest.
Watch.
In a few minutes, movement catches Mariana's eye. Bright blue feathers appear, and Mariana picks out a pointy beak and eyes surrounded by gold.
There it is!
She shouts, too excited to stay quiet. The bird is about 1 meter long.
Hyacinth macaws are the largest parrots in the world,
Fernanda says.
They prefer lightly forested grasslands like this instead of the rainforest.
The bird flies to a palm tree and gathers nuts, and then it brings them back to its nest in the tree.
This must be the father macaw,
Fernanda says.
The father goes out looking for food to bring back to the babies resting in the nest with the mother.
Fernanda hands the pair of binoculars back to Mariana. Mariana watches the bright blue bird fly further away to collect an unripe mango.
They eat it before it's ripe?
She asks. Fernanda nods.
They also eat seeds poisonous to other species. We believe macaws are able to digest fruits and seeds dangerous to other animals because macaws also eat clay from riverbanks.
How does the clay help? Mariana asks.
We're not sure, but we think the chunks of clay macaws eat must absorb the poisons.
Fernanda explains. Macaws eat clay and tapirs eat salt. Mariana realizes that some animals have strange eating habits.
Macaws serve an important function in the forest,
Fernanda says.
As they eat fruits and nuts, they disperse seeds all over the savanna that will someday grow into more trees. So macaws help regenerate their own habitat.
Mariana thinks that is just like the lowland tapirs. Fernanda leads Mariana to a different wooden deck. She wants Mariana to see an entire flock of hyacinth macaws. On the way, Fernanda points out a pointy and irregular hill of dirt erupting from the ground.
That is a termite mound,
Fernanda says. Ew, termites!
Where there are termites, there are giant armadillos,
Fernanda says.
I know armadillos have a bony shell that looks like armor,
Mariana says.
The skin underneath is scaly.
Yes, that is true,
agrees Fernanda.
But what is a giant armadillo?
Mariana asks.
As the name implies, the giant armadillo is a much larger species,
Fernanda explains.
It can grow to 1.5 meters in length. It can weigh up to 58 kilograms.
That's big! What else do they eat?
Mariana asks.
They also eat ants.
Fernanda keeps walking through the forest.
They have strong legs and sharp claws to reach even the tallest termite mounds.
They must be difficult to hunt with claws and a shell, Mariana says.
They are hunted by jaguars and pumas,
Fernanda says.
And like so many other animals in the Amazon, giant armadillos are endangered.
Mariana is sad to hear how many species in her country are endangered.
Here we are,
Fernanda announces.
Climb up.
When they arrive at the new platform, Mariana counts 18 bright blue macaws before losing count. The birds fly from branch to branch, wheel around under the canopy, and squawk and scream.
It sounds like they're yelling at each other, Mariana says.
Macaws make a few different sounds to mark their territory and to identify members of their flock,
Fernanda says. Even while watching the macaws in awe, Mariana thinks about all the animals she visited during this week of school vacation.
Are hyacinth macaws endangered too? She asks Fernanda.
Fernanda nods.
Yes, macaws are endangered. Just like with otters, tapirs, and tamarins. One of the biggest reasons is habitat loss.
Mariana nods. The reasons are becoming familiar.
Mechanized agriculture, cattle ranching, and hydroelectric power all require land cleared of trees and brush,
Fernanda says.
Without the trees and brush, the land isn't fit for the species you have observed.
Mariana realizes that hyacinth macaws are pretty birds with their bright blue and gold feathers.
I bet people would like to have macaws as pets, too.
Yes, which is why buying and selling endangered animals is illegal. The laws don't stop everyone, however.
Fernanda hands a canteen to Mariana. Mariana takes a long drink. The heat makes her thirsty.
Another problem for macaws is the feather art made by local Indians,
Fernanda says.
Tourists love the beautiful artwork and are willing to pay a lot of money for it.
What is feather art? Mariana asks.
Local Indian populations in the Amazon had rituals that often involved costumes, masks, and headdresses. These costumes were made from feathers, snakeskin, bark, insect casings, plant fibers, and seeds.
Fernanda explains.
Those are a lot of materials, Mariana says.
Feathers from many species of birds and of all colors are important to their costumes,
Fernanda continues.
What a lot of poor birds, Mariana thinks.
Headdresses were made by weaving the different materials together,
Fernanda tells her.
They are tied around a person's head for a particular ritual.
What kind of rituals? Mariana asks.
Coming of age ceremonies, baby naming ceremonies, weddings, and funerals. Such events are popular in many cultures,
Fernanda says.
In addition, shamans, native healers, wore full-body costumes made of feathers and plant fibers during healing rituals.
Healing rituals? Mariana frowns.
Yes. Now, we have doctors and medicines to cure those who are sick or injured. Ancient cultures used items from nature to make people better,
Fernanda explains.
Herbs, seeds, and rituals.
Can't they make art with feathers that fall off naturally? Mariana asks.
Fernanda smiles.
Yes, and that is what we are trying to teach people. We suggest they use fallen feathers instead of trapping and killing the birds first.
Mariana looks thoughtful. It has been an amazing week in the rainforest. She hopes she can visit again soon.